Evening, ma'am. I'm Detective Martinez from the LAPD. This is my partner, Detective Williams. Or we can find Monica St. John here.
Yes.
May we speak with her, please?
She's resting.
Understandable.
Find her?
No, ma'am. I'm afraid we didn't.
You know she killed my boy, too.
Yes, ma'am. We're very sorry for your loss. Believe me, we're doing everything we can to find her.
Well, you're not trying hard enough.
We did find a blood trail leading into the woods. Possible. She may have died in the woods and the animals got to her.
So you think she's dead?
Well, ma'am, it's possible, but we're just not sure yet. In the meantime, I've assigned a couple guys to watch over the place for a while, if that's all right.
All right, would that be all?
Yes, that's all for now. But if you wouldn't mind, take my card. If you see or hear anything out of the ordinary, why don't you go ahead and give us a call? Once again, we're truly sorry for your loss.
Thank you.
If she's alive, we will find her.
I sure hope so.
Good night.
You're safe now, Monica.
Thank you for taking care of me.
Oh, sweetie. You're all that I have now. I'm not gonna let anyone take you from me. Look, I have something for you.
That's beautiful.
Dwayne gave me this when I turned 40 last year. And I think that you should have it. But promise me that you'll never take it off.
You'll always wear it. I promise. I won't ever take it off.
Oh, sweetie.
You handle all this woman, huh?
Hell.
Huh? Ah. Oh, Poppy.
Huh? Like that? Like that? Can you handle all this?
Oh, yeah, I do, Poppy.
Remember me? You're not Troy.
The fuck is Troy?
One lucky motherfucker.
That was it. That was hot. every time they come up. Rhapsody, give it up for them right now. Thank you for coming tonight. Unfortunately, though, tonight is Rhapsody's last performance with us for a few weeks. I know, what can we do? But band member Robbie is getting married to Mo this weekend. Don't do it. No, I'm just saying, no. Only give him a hand. Give it up for him, honestly. There it is. Yeah, yeah.
That's good. What is
it? It's beautiful. That's amazing.
It really is. This place is amazing.
The owner is a friend of the family, so we got a really good deal on it.
I'm sorry, I'm so happy right now.
Oh, Mo.
Oh, Lily.
I mean, you should be. A perfect man, great friends, your own band. How lucky can a bitch get?
Thanks, Mick. I do feel blessed, I do, but it's not my band. It's our band.
That's right, to Rhapsody.
That's Rhapsody!
Yeah. Rhapsody!
You know, Miss Shears, right, you do have this perfect guy right here.
Huh? Yes, I do. So, whose idea was it to have it at a plantation house?
Well,
it was actually my idea.
But don't creep y'all a little bit considering, you know, what happened to our people up there?
No, no. You know, I like the idea of turning something that was so ugly into something beautiful.
Yo, I'm feeling that. You're killing the game with that. For real.
Thank you.
Well, as far as the scheduling goes, the wedding party will all drive up tomorrow. Rehearsal and rehearsal brunches on Saturday. Sunday is the big day, at noon, of course. And as of now, we have 94 confirmed guests.
Hold on. I didn't hear anything about my bachelor party. I got it all set up for tomorrow night at Magic Titty.
Magic Titty?
Oh, yeah.
No. No.
Robbie?
No, no. Baby, you didn't tell them?
Tell me what?
Yeah, about that, no bachelor party, bro.
No, no, you can't take that away from me. No bachelor party, bro?
No bachelorette party, neither?
Not exactly. I thought it would be cute to have a joint bachelorette and bachelor party.
That'd be sexy.
And Mo already agreed.
Yes, I did. I think it will be good, clean, fun.
Good and clean will never be fun.
Whatever, Slick.
Okay, this is what's gonna happen. The groomsmen, you guys are gonna strip for us, and then we're gonna strip for you guys.
So I guess I have to pack something sexy.
Yep, but no TNA.
Good.
A little bit.
Yeah, my little side movie ain't never hurt nobody.
I got just the right thong for this.
Okay,
you know what?
You know what?
What?
I ain't cool with this. Unless your fine ass cousin Rena gonna be stripping too, then I'm good.
Oh. Excuse me, y'all. I gotta take this call.
Yo, is that the cousin who's a stripper, dog?
Ex-stripper. She's acting now. Right.
Well, look, fellas, you guys are gonna have so much fun. We did this last year for my best friend's wedding, and we had a blast.
Yes, everything is set.
Hey, everybody.
Hi, Mom.
Sorry it took me a minute to get here. Is everybody good?
Oh, you're great.
What is that? Yeah, I brought you something good.
Oh,
here, pass it back.
Ask me some of that sugar.
Here you go.
What is this that I hear about a dress?
I found the perfect dress yesterday.
Well, sweetie, I thought that, you know, we agreed that you were gonna use my mother's dress. I mean, I got it all prepared for you.
I'm sorry, Mom. Everything was moving really fast. And I was gonna tell you yesterday, but don't worry, you're gonna love this dress, I promise. You really are.
Yeah, it really is gorgeous, ma'am. Really is.
So, where'd you get it?
Well, my mother got a hookup on a couture dress, so I got her one.
Oh, that's very nice.
Your food is just delicious, Miss Crane.
Mm. Thank you, dear.
It really is, Ma.
Enjoy.
Mm-mm.
Somebody's upset you.
I'll leave her alone.
Was that him?
Yes, that was him.
Ooh, when do we get to meet the mystery man?
Hopefully Sunday at the wedding.
Looks like our boy is falling hard.
I'll give it a month.
Hater, I think they make a cute couple.
Yeah, you would.
Hey, any cute boys coming to this party?
It's gonna be dudes there, but not for you. They're all straight, man.
So?
I've turned many a so-called straight, even a few celebs, thank you very much.
Yeah, like who? Because I've heard some rumors.
See that? It's cats like you that's responsible for all them dudes on the DL right now.
No. See, I don't make nobody do nothing they don't want to do.
Don't touch me. Never misunderstand
it. Hey, babe, is your brother going to be okay rolling up by herself?
Yeah, she's fine. Look, guys, we just passed 500,000 Twitter followers. Yeah.
All right. That's what I'm talking about.
How many Facebook likes we got?
388,000 likes, baby.
Yo. Radio programmers getting high, getting paid, getting laid to play
20 songs. You okay?
Yeah, I feel dizzy. I need to stop.
Okay, I'm gonna pull over. You okay? You all right?
I'm going with you. No. I just need a minute. I'll be back.
Robbie, what's the matter with Monique?
I think she's having another one of those anxiety attacks.
Okay, look, I'm gonna go check on her.
All right.
Gonna be okay?
Yeah, she just needs a minute, man. She gets these anxiety attacks every once in a while.
You know, real talk, I think it may have something to do with the fact you two haven't fucked in like 6 months.
Wait, what? See, that's why do I tell you anything, man?
I'm just saying, trying to help you.
It has been a minute. We haven't made love since we've been engaged, but that has nothing to do with it, fool.
I don't know, man. I mean, I'd be having mad panic attacks, too, if I went 6 months without no pussy.
Now, why are we best friends again?
Well, we boys, because without me, your music would suck ass.
Okay, it suck. Well, I can always find a good drummer in Miami.
Not this good.
Yeah. Anyway, man, she's worth it, though. I mean, don't get it twisted. It ain't easy. But in 2 days, boy, somebody's going to be walking bow-legged.
That somebody might be your ass.
Hey. Just holy shit. You all right, babe? You okay?
Yeah.
You good? You all right?
Why wouldn't I be?
Martin Johnson. He is the property manager and his colleague Horatio. Martin and his family have been associated with this property for over 6 generations. So, he'd like to say a few words.
Good evening, everybody. I want to welcome y'all and tell y'all a little something about the Douglas Plantation. The main house was built way back in 1815. So there's a whole lot of history running around here, if you know what I mean. Now, the property was turned into a hotel some 60 years ago. There's some stuff you ought to know. See them funny-looking dials over there? Owners got these real expensive gollywog rag dials. Now, if you do fine, take pictures of them, but please, don't pick them up or touch them.
Damn, it's hot in here.
Sorry, little lady, we ain't got no air conditioning. But them fans, they could do just fine. Also, them cellular phones, they won't work in the house. Seems the only place they seem to work is outside. So the further away from the house, the better. Now, the house phones only work for local calls. But when it rains, for some strange reason, they don't work. But you ain't got to worry about that this weekend. We fixing to have real good weather this weekend. Now, I can't be with y'all this weekend because I got a family matter I got to deal with, but Horatio, he will be here. Horatio stays on the property. He's got a pager. All you got to do is dial zero from any phone in the house. He'll get right back to you. Now, his English ain't that good, but he can understand a lot better. He can speak it. Any questions?
Yes, are there any convenience stores or markets nearby?
Yeah, Willie's. Up the road about 2 miles. You can't miss it.
Thank you.
I think he closes in about an hour. Now, should you get up there? I want you to say hello to Ralphie. Don't let him scare you, now.
Okay.
Any more questions? Good. Now, you kids have a real nice time here. And I want you to tell all your good friends up in the big city about the good time you had down here at the Douglas Plantation House. Good night.
Okay, everyone. Y'all can get your room assignments and keys from Horatio. In the meantime, I know that Marion is preparing some of her delicious desserts. So just enjoy yourselves and this wonderful home. And I'll see all y'all later for the bachelor and bachelorette party.
Yay! Would anybody like anything from the store?
Can you pick me up a box of figs, please?
Boy, don't you stop eating those things. They're gonna rot your teeth out.
Thanks, Mom.
I'll see what I can do.
Thank you.
I'll come with you, Mom.
Oh, yeah. Come with us, Vicky. Come on.
You're not back.
It's change and like, it's like, you know, like a presentation. I don't have to be walking down the aisle, so I think it'd be good to do something that's a little different. That's, you know, like a presentation of the bride. And you know
wait,
what I'm
wait
saying?
Wait a minute. What is the police doing here?
Oh, that's Michael. It's Claire's new boyfriend.
Yeah. Is he a foreigner, too?
He's a cute foreigner. Hey, Mike, it's good to see you again.
Congratulations.
Thank you.
How you doing? Mike. Mike Crump. Nice to meet you.
Okay.
Okay.
Pleasure.
Here. Yes. All right. Crump, Michael Crump.
Claire's inside, so.
Thanks. Nice to meet you. Ladies.
Really? That's what we're going to be doing? We're just going to be rude?
Let's go.
Just the whole weekend. We're just going to be rude to people.
Let's go.
Not say hi to them or be pleasant.
Smoking with the police in here like this?
Oh, man, that's my mom's new dude, Mike. He's cooler than a fan, man. He's cool as fuck.
Hi. Hi. Mike, this is my niece, Rena.
It's nice to meet you.
So you're Officer Crumkey. Auntie talked about you the whole way up.
Don't exaggerate. And it's Crump, not Crumkey.
Oh, don't worry about it. I get it all the time. So she talked about me the whole way up, huh?
Yeah. The whole way.
Maybe just a bit.
Mm-hmm.
That's nice to finally meet you. This is Susie. She's in my cousin's band.
Hi.
Nice to meet you.
Hey, do you guys mind if I take a picture of y'all?
No.
Oh, come, Rena. Yeah, come.
Come on in.
Oh. Oh, that's perfect. My gosh, so much love. I gotta load these.
Rastafari.
Hello, boys.
Hey, Ross.
What up?
Do y'all mind if I borrow Anthony just for a minute?
Only if you promise not to take advantage of Anthony.
I promise.
Now, please take advantage of me.
Crazy.
Bye, Anthony.
She brought out the white.
Yo, that's one strange dude, man.
Which one? Both the motherfuckers creep me the fuck out.
For real, it's like Candyman and Freddy Krueger them became boys.
Hey, look at Tony. He is determined to get in her dirty drawers this weekend.
But he won't. Homegirl is way out of his league.
No doubt, but you can't knock a man's hustle, though.
Where they going anyway?
They probably used the phone.
Oh, yeah, old man did say something about that.
See, that's how folks end up missing and shit.
Yeah. So, Allison.
That's my name.
What side you tripping for, man? The males or the females?
Duh. You're the groom. I think I'm a strip for
I'm
your
gone, ass. Come on, man.
You liked it.
Negative.
No, he should strip for us.
Thank you, Rena.
Yeah, but he's stripping for the girls.
You still hot?
Is that the best you got?
No, I got a lot more than that.
Later.
That's your.
Just drop the walls, man. Drop the walls. Get the defenses low.
Puerto Ricans, but Rosalind Ann is also freaking. I like her in a dress. A big old chesa.
Oh, my God. Anthony, I can't right now. I can't do this right now. I've just got... I've got so much on my mind. I can't. Oh, man. Mm. You taste so good.
Man, you taste like that sweet honey bun cake my mama makes.
I can't right now. I can't. But if you're good...
Then maybe later.
Damn! Somebody out there? Hello? Hello? Anybody there?
Honestly, do you think you could try to be nice to her?
Look, I'm trying.
Yeah, but it's difficult. I mean, I'm not gonna lie, it's difficult. I mean, they're not like us. They're foreigners. See, I was just really hoping that you were gonna meet a nice American boy like my Dwayne.
Okay, first of all, he is American. He was born in New York. And Dwayne's gone, you know? It's been 6 years. I have to move on. I'm in love again, and I need you to be happy for me.
I'm really trying. I'm really trying.
Hey, we all set?
Yeah, we're all set.
That was an awfully long phone call.
Yeah, that was, Rosalind Ann. You know, wedding stuff. That was all about Mo right now.
So her phone works at the house?
Yeah, yes.
Hey, are you, Ralphie?
No, that's that crazy nigger out front. Why don't y'all take him with you?
Okay, how much do I owe you, sir?
$17.50.
Okay, here is $20. You just keep the change.
Thanks.
It's good. Keep it.
See y'all later.
Bye.
Did I scare you?
Yeah. I thought you were blind.
I see fine, but my eyes don't work.
I think Martin up at Douglas Plantation told me to tell you hi.
Y'all staying there?
Yeah, I'm getting married there this weekend.
That place is cursed by the blood of them 13 slaves. You're all damned fools if you stay. Leave. Leave that place now.
Probably drunk out of his mind. Come on, let's go.
Leave before it's too late. Leave before they take your very soul. By tomorrow, you'll all be dead.
I love it. Thank you, Claire.
You look so beautiful.
This is amazing, Claire.
I'm getting so skinny.
I've been dieting.
Every bride does.
Yeah. Ma?
Wow.
What do you think, Mom?
Wow. It's beautiful.
Thank you. Well, thank Claire.
Mo, you like it?
Oh, I wanted to talk to you about the locket thing.
The locket thing?
Claire, can you give us a moment?
Of course, thanks. Thanks.
Mom, this is really hard for me, but I just don't think it's right wearing my ex-fiancé's picture, you know, on my wedding day. I'm sorry. I know how much it meant to you, but I just feel like we need to move on. No? Dwayne is gone.
Of course, yes. I understand. No.
I'm sorry.
No, of course I understand. You know, excuse me, I left the rose in the oven.
Is everything all right?
Yeah, everything's fine.
Gonna be okay.
Yeah.
Just breathe, darling.
Mickey, you are not going to the party like that.
Isn't this sexy?
Are you serious?
No, I'm not serious, but I don't know if I'm gonna make the party tonight.
Why not?
I got really bad cramps.
No, you have to come. This was your idea, remember?
I know, but I just wanna lay down and maybe see how I feel.
I have something. It's my doll. It always works for me.
Well, thank you.
I hope you feel better.
Oh, you look amazing.
Thank you.
We'll have fun tonight.
Oh,
I will.
Okay. Pain that went from wanting to marry me to wanting to marry me. Nerdy girls want to study my human anatomy. I humor relaxedly, pause about half a beat. The jump back on the street like I was Johnny D. Debt paid for all those years that I wasn't me. Oh.
didn't mean to startle you like that.
What can I do for you, Claire?
Well, you seemed pretty upset the last time I saw you, and I just wanted to make sure you're okay.
I'm fine. Now, what do you really want?
I just wanted to remind you that my son doesn't eat swine, so please don't put no pork or pork products in the food. Also, there's some Jamaican patties in the fridge. Can you heat them up and cut them into halves? They're made for great snacks, and everybody loves them. Okay?
Okay.
Thank you much, darling. Woo! It's gonna be a wonderful wedding.
Yes, it is.
Girl is wild.
But she still knows how.
Yes, shut up, Slick.
Okay. All right, fellas. Y'all have had your show. Now it's our turn, so get up on your feet.
Yeah. On your feet. Nope. Let's do it. Work it.
On your feet.
Just keep playing music.
No. 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 No way. I'll play. Get up there. Let's go. Everybody up.
Monique, how did your maid of honor get out of this?
Yeah, how'd she get out of doing this?
Cramps. Lucky girl.
All right.
There's our beauty.
Nice to see you again.
You look perfect. When do we start?
When they're ready.
Oh. Mike, wait.
Come on, baby, I ain't seen you in over a week.
I know, but it's the season finale. Please, just let me wait until the show goes off, and then I'm all yours. I can't believe this is happening.
Miss Calvet, could you step in, please?
Well, what am I supposed to do, Turbo?
You play with my iPad. It's the new one.
I'll be back.
Where are you going?
For a smoke.
God, I wish you wouldn't. But if you do, please brush your teeth before you come back to bed, okay?
Mm-hmm. Hey, what's wrong? Help me with that. What's wrong?
Everybody hates me.
No, I'm sure that's not the case.
Yes, it is. At least all the girls do.
Oh, well, you're very beautiful. They're probably just jealous.
You think I'm beautiful?
Yeah, I do. Mo?
Thanks.
You know I love you. That bitch.
Tell Robbie and Monique, I'm real sorry, and I wish them the best.
I could do that. But for real, between me and you, I'd have hit that shit too.
Take it from me, man. It wasn't worth it. See you around.
All right.
About.
It's a black thing, baby. You wouldn't understand.
What? And you would?
Yeah, I do.
There is nothing black about getting caught cheating on your girlfriend, Anthony. Assholes, they come in all colors. I knew that girl was bad news.
Yeah?
Follow me, silly. I need to make another phone call.
All right. Yo, it is nice out here tonight, huh?
Yeah, I can give you service.
You see, I'm like an Oreo cookie, but really like a reverse Oreo cookie because I look white, but I'm all black on the inside. It's like those people who...
Hey, Brooke, it's Rosalind Ann. It's getting kind of late, so I'm just going to stay the night out here tonight, and I will see you in the morning. Oh, and it looks like we all going to need the 50 extra chairs for the guests coming up in the morning. Okay, I'll see you then. Bye.
Like I was saying... It's kind of like a girl, you know, born like a lesbian.
Anthony, stop fooling yourself. You are as white as I am.
Nah, definitely not.
Do you know how I know this? If you were black, would you be standing out in the woods in the middle of the night? Exactly.
Alright, you got me. But for real, I'm all black from the waist down.
Oh, is that so? Uh-huh. Are you gonna show me?
If you ask nicely, maybe.
Get over here.
Ain't nothing but a gangster party.
Oh, my God.
Oh, I like your hair like this.
I like your boobs like this. Yeah, I got a confession to make.
Oh my God, don't tell me you're a virgin.
Nah, but you're my first.
Your first what?
My first white girl.
Stop playing. You've never been with a white girl before?
Nah.
Well, then I must represent for my people.
Oh, shit.
You see what you've been missing?
Uh-huh. Yes. Am I your first?
My first what?
Your first brother.
Oh my God, you are definitely not black, Anthony.
I?
No, you're not black.
I?
No, you're not black.
I?
Oh my God, you are black.
How about now,
yeah,
bitch?
You're black.
Yeah.
Oh my God, you're so
how about
black,
now?
Anthony.
I?
Do you think she's gonna be okay?
Eventually. But she has the worst luck with dudes, though. And I was beginning to like his punk ass, too.
I can't believe he did that. He seemed like such a nice guy.
You see, this could have all been avoided if she had just let me hit it.
There you go. If your game was tight, it probably wouldn't even happen.
My game is tight. Matter of fact, she might just need a friend right now.
No. No, she doesn't. Because you know what? You would just end up making things worse, and we don't need that. So, no.
Real talk. Could it get any worse?
With you involved? Hell yeah.
Well, you definitely ain't hitting it now.
Watch me play. Watch and learn.
He'll probably just end up getting the door slammed in his face.
You up, nigga, peep the language, it's universal. You play with fire, it may hurt you or burn you. Lessons are blessings you should learn through, let's face facts. Although MCs lays tracks, it doesn't mean behind the scenes there ain't no dirt to trace back. That goes for all of us, there ain't nobody to trust. It's like sabotage.
Just in case you didn't know, going solo. What I've done up to all this upon you, hoes. Get more guys to help me run the whole joint. Cultivate, motivate, or else we'll die. You know I'll be the master of the who, what, where, and why. See when you're shining, some chumps will want to dull ya. Always selfish, jealous punks will want to pull ya down. Just like some shellfish in a bucket, cause they love it to see your ass squirm like a worm. But just as you receive what is coming to you, everybody else is gonna get this too. I ain't no saint, therefore I cannot dispute that everyone must meet their moment of truth. Have reactions, don't be quick to judge. You may not know the hardships people don't speak of. It's best to step back and observe with coup, for we all must meet our moment of truth. Sometimes you gotta dig deep. When problems come near, don't fear. Things get severe for everybody, everywhere. Why do bad things happen to good people? Seems that life is just a constant war between good and evil. Scare you guys, but
this old blind guy is telling me at the market how how this place is cursed by the spirits of murdered slaves.
Whoa, wait, are you saying this place is haunted?
There's an old newspaper clipping on the wall over there about the Douglas 13. I took some pictures of it. Apparently they were runaway slaves. And when they were captured, the owner buried all 13 of them alive in front of the other slaves to set an example.
Really?
But it doesn't say anything about ghosts or the house being haunted.
See, that's some fucked up shit there.
So they're murdered and they were buried like someplace around here?
Yep. The article says they were buried on the property.
Hold on. Y'all know there's 13 of us, right?
You know what? You're right. There are 13 of us. What a coincidence.
Well, maybe it ain't no coincidence, Mo.
That's real fucked up what they did, but it would make a sick horror flick, though.
You know what? I bet the white people would die first in that movie.
Do I count?
Oh, honey, you a goner. I'm sorry.
But seriously, why would 13 angry dead slaves fuck with us? I mean, we're the descendants and we turned out pretty fucking good. Now, Tony and that wedding planner chick, and I hate to say you too, Susie, y'all the ones that need to be worried. Bottom line, they ain't fucking with us. Either way, I ain't afraid no.
Oh, shit.
Yo, you alright, Dan? You alright, bro?
Yeah, I'm
good. Well, I ain't fucking okay. I gotta go. I'm sorry. It's my nerves. I'll see you guys in the morning. Somebody wanna walk me to my room?
No.
Rude.
Ava, go check on Mom?
Nah, bro. I'll be up in a minute.
No, I'll go with you, baby. Wait, have you guys seen Rosalind Ann?
Her car's still here.
Okay. But she has to be here because nobody knows how many people are coming in the morning for breakfast.
Last time I saw her, she was walking towards the woods with Tony.
You think we should go check on them?
Nah, they're white. They'll be all right.
I'll see you guys in the morning.
All right, later.
Bye.
Didn't that old dude said it wasn't gonna rain this weekend?
He did. Hey, do you mind if I take some pictures of you?
Nah. I know I look good.
Los tres hermanos Mora
vivieron con sus padres, Igor y Mabel. Y el resto de la historia, ya todos la conocen.
Some good shit, huh?
Thanks for the weed slick. But I need you to leave now.
I don't think you should be alone right now.
I'll be fine.
Sometimes it helps to talk these things out, you know what I mean?
You ain't fooling nobody, slick. You don't want to talk, you just want to fuck. And there's no chance of that happening. Not tonight, not ever.
Oh. Look, you got me all wrong. Look, I'm a really good listener.
No, Slick. I know exactly what you are. And I'm good. But thanks anyway.
Look, hold up. Damn. We can talk about this? Gotta help each other out.
leaving.
Can I get like a goodnight kiss or something?
No.
Okay. All right. Shit.
I'm really attracted to you, but I can't. I swear. If I didn't love my boyfriend so much, I'd fuck the shit out of you right now.
Nah, I think it would be the other way around.
Well, it'd be one big fucking mess up in here.
Your boy's one lucky dude.
So do you want to see the rest of those pictures?
Yeah, sure. What the fuck is that?
I don't know. Ah! Hey, did you hear that?
Hear what? You okay? Huh?
Yeah. Yeah, I'm okay.
I'm fine. Probably one of them ghosts of one of them dead Pickney slaves you was talking about. You know, in Jamaica, we don't call them ghosts.
What do you call them?
Dopey! And Dopey know if it's frightened.
Okay, you know what, Mom? Let me get that bottle, man.
Nuh-uh, my brethren, you got to get your own.
Really, Mom? Just like that?
Slick, I'm not.
Is this a joke? Well, you better put that back before you get us kicked out of this house.
Get out of here. I'm gonna get that bottle, okay? All right?
Yes, sir.
Mm-hmm.
Well, get some sleep, Claire, okay? Oh. We have a big day ahead of us tomorrow.
Okay.
Hopefully the rain will stop.
I'm sure it will. Oh, you two make such a beautiful couple. Oh, and I can't wait to call you my daughter.
Oh.
You know, I've always wanted one.
Well, I can't wait to call you my mom.
Oh!
Well, no, my other mom. Get some sleep, okay?
All right, get some rest, Mom.
Night.
Good night, Claire.
I have to apologize for my mom.
Mm. Oh, it's okay. She's crazy, but she's cool.
Yeah.
Speaking of moms, I gotta check on mine, or else I'll never hear the end of it.
Oh, yeah, was she okay with that whole locket thing? Yeah, what a night, huh?
Where is everybody?
Probably exhausted. You know, it's been a long night.
Stop! No.
Yeah. Boy, you know. I want you. Come on, babe. Are you serious? Nobody gotta know?
Be strong, black man. Besides, I have something very special planned for you on our wedding night.
Mm.
I love you.
Yeah, I love you too.
About this.
The mob is after them.
Be moving someplace safe.
But only one woman can protect them.
Hello.
I got soul for you, fam.
They're sleeping still.
You're so huge, like a giant bag of Skittles. You better get
the hell out by when I it's open. You know what's gonna happen.
Hey, Mom.
Hey. Didn't think I was gonna see you again tonight.
Yeah, I know. I'm sorry. It's just Robbie wanted to go check on Claire, and then we ended up playing cards for hours, so.
Oh. I guess she's more important than me.
No, of course not.
Well, it's just, I mean, I don't know. You seem close to what's her name.
Can't I love you both?
I guess. Hey, you gonna play cards with me?
I didn't even know you played cards.
Yeah, you could teach me.
Yeah, maybe another time. You know, it's late, and there's a lot to do tomorrow. We have to get up early.
Of course. Another time.
Yeah. You want me to wake you up in the morning?
Oh, no, I'm gonna get up early.
Are you sure? Because you know how hard you sleep. I would hate for you to oversleep.
I won't oversleep.
Okay. What's that?
Oh, well, that's just something I'm working on. It's a surprise.
Okay.
I love her little kiddo. Do they know about us?
No. But I'm gonna tell him. Soon. Good night, Mom.
Good night, Monica.
Giant bag of Skittles.
You better get the hell out, boy. When I come back up here, you know what's gonna happen. You gonna taste the rainbow.
Lydia's witness protection. Her butt must be hungry because it's chewing her dress like.
Hello? Hello?
Really?
Hey. What's up?
What's going on, Slick?
You want to hit this?
You talk about the joint? Damn.
That's some good shit.
Yeah, this is that Jamaican since me la mon.
Really?
Really?
All that?
All this.
Help. Hold on. You just give me a minute. I just need to
hurry up.
Okay. Ready for some thunder?
Wait. You must be the duppy. You don't scare me. Mickey? Is that you? Mickey? Mickey, are you still in there? Okay, I'm coming in.
Mickey.
My cell phone to call the police.
Oh, right. Baby, it's raining. My hair's gonna get wet.
Are you serious right now? You know what? You stay here.
Shit, I'm coming.
I think he's gone.
No, señor. No, don't, don't worry. No preocupe por mí, señor. Asesino. Asesino en la casa. Killer. Killer here, señor. Run. Run, señor. Corre. Corre. Go. Run away. Corre, señor. Go. Go now, señor. Go.
You killed him.
No, somebody else got to him. But clearly he didn't kill Mickey. But I think he knows who did and he was trying to warn us.
So who then?
Well, I don't know. We gotta warn everybody and let them know fast.
Oh my God. What if they're all dead?
Oh. Don't start that, all right? That's not possible. No, no, whoa, whoa. Give me that. Give me that. That's not possible. Just give me this, all right? Calm down. Let me have it. All right, let's go. Come on.
Oh, my God.
Oh. What the fuck is he doing in Alton's bed anyway? What the fuck is doing this shit? Babe, you don't think it's that serial killer again, do you?
What if he followed me here?
Well, I thought you said he didn't know who you were. And then why would he wait 6 years if that don't make any sense? Wait a minute. Corre, señor! Corre! Run! Run!
Yourself is. What is it about you that makes people go crazy?
It's not me. I've been nothing but good to you.
Oh, have you really?
Yes, I have.
Is that why you've treated me like the goddamn maid for the past 6 months?
Oh my God. I had no idea you felt that way.
I gave up everything for you. I paid for that surgery. I sold my business. I moved to this godforsaken state all because of you. And you treat that bitch of a Jamaican more like a mother than you ever treated me. And you wouldn't even wear my mama's dress when you knew how much that meant to me. But you know what? I was willing to go along with it. Because I couldn't love you like my own. I had even forgiven you for my Dwayne's death. I had nothing to do with Dwayne's death. I loved him. Oh, if you hadn't treated your crazy ass sister so bad, that bitch wouldn't have lost her goddamn mind and killed everybody. So yes, you are to blame. So own it. When you took that locket off your neck and you swore to me that you would never take it off, that's when it hit me. For the first time, I saw who you really were. You wanted to replace my Dwayne with that Jamaican fella and me with his family. I mean, don't you see? I gave you that face!
You belong to me! You were supposed to replace the emptiness I felt after you took my Dwayne away. Now I have nothing. You took it all. So you see, kiddo, you left me no choice.
Oh, my God. So you killed them all?
Oh, no. No.
Come here, bitch. Get out of here. Get in. Get in.
Oh, my God. How did you find me?
No, she didn't find you. She found me on Facebook. Can you believe this bitch is actually one of my Facebook friends?
Why would you do this with her? She killed Dwayne.
I know. She killed my boy, my only child. And she's gonna pay for that real soon. You know, I didn't come here intending to hurt nobody. I mean, I didn't even think I could kill anybody. I killed a chicken once, but that was creepy. But I saw her kill those kids out in the woods. Ooh, this bitch is one gold piece. She just left them out there. And then I started thinking, you know, killing really can't be that hard if you're motivated. And thanks to you, kiddo, I got really motivated. I mean, it turns out killing folks isn't that difficult. So I followed her. And I decided to kill two birds with one stone. Anyway, so then she comes down to the kitchen. Oh, Lord. I guess she was looking for me. But I surprised her ass, didn't I? Bam! Oh, I knocked that bitch out cold. Bam! Oh. But she got the horny cop's gun. And then, that's when I took off. You know what? Killing is kind of addictive. but wait a minute. My favorite one was that Mexican. Now, you can thank me for that. You know that motherfucker was a pervert. His ass was a peeping Tom. That asshole had a peephole in his room that went to all the girls' room. So if you was naked, oh, he saw all your goodies. But not to worry, because mama took good care of his ass. I had just finished off that strip of chicken. And I heard this noise in the wall. He looked so scared. I think he saw me kill the stripper. And you know, he was playing with himself, the little sick fuck. So I had to act fast.
Hello?
Ah, señor.
Bien. I stabbed him! Stabbed him again, just to make sure.
Why did you have to kill everybody?
You know, I guess crazy is as crazy does.
Listen to yourself, Mom.
Oh, you can stop calling me Mom.
This isn't you, Marion. This isn't the woman I know and love. After you're hurting. You need help, Marion. Okay? Give me the gun. I'll testify on your behalf. After what you've been through, a jury will understand. Everyone's gonna understand.
Your jury understand that, Monica? You don't know shit, kiddo. Because if you did, you wouldn't be here right now. So let me tell you what. You got two options. Option A, we leave here together and start over. I mean, the story's very obvious. Psycho sister returns, tries to finish off the job, kills all your friends again. You protect the mama, kill the crazy sister, and we live a nice, long, happy life, right? Or option B, I shoot you, I shoot me. Oops, I guess that's the end of that story. So what will it be, Monica?
Do you really think we could start over?
Well, I'm willing to forgive if you're willing to forget.
Okay, Mom. Let's start over. Can I get a hug?
Okay, look, okay. We gotta make this look like your sister attacked me, okay? So, let's untie. So here, take this.
Okay.
You're gonna untie her. Come on. Untie her. Untie her. Untie her hands and don't forget her feet, too.
Yeah, that's right.
Yeah. We're gonna make it look like. You should make it seem like. Ah! Oh, shit! Ooh, David, you can't trust anybody these days! Your insides are open, but I guess
bullet in the head. You just have to do. Go ahead. I have nothing to live for anyway. Me either. Kiddo.
Goodbye, Monica.
I think that belongs to me.
Hey, little horny guy. This really is like none of your business. Please. Shoot her!
I don't want to shoot anyone. Please, ma'am, put the weapon down.
No! Is she dead?
Yeah, I'm afraid so. Sidearm. What the hell happened here?
She went crazy. Killed the entire wedding party.
Wait a minute. Wasn't she your mother?
Not anymore.
I need all units down to the Douglas Plantation. We got a major homicide. There's got to be 12 bodies here.
No, 13. It's 13 bodies.
Correction, 13 bodies.
and do your thing with could set you up and wet you up. Nigga, peep the language, it's universal. You play with fire, it may hurt you or burn you. Lessons are blessings you should learn to. Let's face facts. Although MCs lace tracks, it doesn't mean behind the scenes there ain't no dirt to trace back. That goes for all of us. There ain't nobody to trust. It's like sabotage. It's got me ready to bust, but I can't jeopardize what I've done up to this point. So I'ma get more guys to help me run the whole joint. Cultivate, multiply, motivate, or else we'll die. You know I'll be the master of the who, what, where, and why. See, when you're shining, some chumps will wanna dull ya. Always selfish, jealous punks will wanna pull ya down. Just like some shellfish in a bucket, cause they love it to see your ass squirm like a worm. But just as you receive what is coming to you, everybody else is gonna get this too. I ain't no saint, therefore I cannot dispute that everyone must meet their moment of truth. Actions have reactions, don't be quick to judge. You may not know the hardships people don't speak of. It's best to step back and observe with coup, for we all must meet our moment of truth. Sometimes you gotta dig deep. When problems come near, don't fear. Things get severe for everybody, everywhere. Why do bad things happen to good people? Seems that life is just a constant war between good and evil. The situation that I'm facing is mad amazing. To think such problems can arise from minor confrontations. Now I'm contemplating in my bedroom pacing. Dark clouds over my head, my heart's racing. Suicide? Nah, I'm not a foolish guy. Don't even feel like drinking or even getting high, cause all that's gonna do really is accelerate the anxieties that I wish I could alleviate. But wait, I've been through a whole lot of other shit before, so I ought to be able to withstand some more.